Welcome to our channel, On the Road. In this video, I am going to show you 10 places you must visit in the Dominican Republic. Here we go. Ten. Santo Domingo's Zona Colonial. In this city, where Christopher Columbus first landed in the Americas, you'll find the hustle and bustle of modern-day life being played out against the backdrop of centuries-old buildings. The colonial architecture, much of which today houses museums, restaurants, shops, and quaint hotels, lines the streets and squares, and takes you back to another era in mind-blowing fashion. Much of the activity focuses around Calle El Conde, the main thoroughfare, and a popular street for shopping or dining El Fresco. Wandering around the various streets, you'll see crumbling ruins, like those of Monasterio de San Francisco, beautifully preserved buildings, such as the Catedral Primada de America, first cathedral in the Americas, which is still in use today, and residential areas, offering a glimpse into local life. Even eating pizza in a restored colonial building on a hot night, or lounging in the courtyard of your 450-year-old hotel, can feel like a unique experience in this beautiful city. Santo Domingo is definitely a place worth spending some time. 9. The resort destination of Punta Cana. Where an endless stretch of beautiful white sand beach meets the emerald waters of the Caribbean is Punta Cana, the Dominican Republic's premier resort destination. If you are looking for luxury all-inclusive resorts, a couple's retreat, or family-friendly accommodation combined with an unending list of water-based activities for entertainment, this is the place to come. Bavaro Beach is Punta Cana's most impressive stretch of beach, where you can wade into the water or walk for hours along the sand. Resorts line the beach and offer easy access to all the activities. This is not a place to come for a quiet getaway. The ocean is a flurry of activity, with boats, parasailers, and tour boats coming and going. Roped-off areas offer safe places to swim. In and from the beach is a smattering of restaurants and retail, most of which are very modern, especially by Dominican Republic standards. 8. Las Galeras. At the farthest tip of the Samana Peninsula, where the road dead ends at the ocean, looking out over one of the area's many beautiful beaches, is the small town of Las Galeras. Its remote location will appeal to independent travelers looking for an off-the-beaten-path experience. Palm-lined, white sand beaches and turquoise water create an idyllic scene. Beaches like Playa Rincon, La Playita, Playa Frontón, and other unnamed stretches of undeveloped beaches in the area are some of the best beaches in the Dominican Republic and offer the polar opposite experience of the major resort destinations on the island. Here, you can hire a boat to take you to a remote beach for a morning or afternoon, or walk from town to several beautiful sandy coves in the surrounding area. The town itself has only one main street, but restaurants along here, many operated by French expats, offer outstanding cuisine at backpacker prices. Restaurants in the surrounding mountains or along the oceanfront cliffs, which require a drive from town, provide more great options. Las Galeras is the perfect place to get away from busy streets and the tourist scene, while still offering enough infrastructure to make you comfortable. 7. La Romana. Not far from Punta Cana, La Romana is one of the Dominican's lesser-known resort destinations. This area has a number of large resorts, some of which are geared towards more independent travelers looking to self-cater. However, the number of resorts here is not nearly on the same scale as Punta Cana. Beautiful beaches in the area are the main draw. One of the most popular things to do here is to visit the Altos de Chavín, where you can shop for crafters and souvenirs in a replica of a 16th-century artisan's village. The village is set off on its own, but you can join an organized shopping trip if you don't have your own transportation. Not far from La Romana is Bahia Hive, a fishing town with a public beach and the departure point for trips to Isla Saona. You can also day trip from La Romana to Santo Domingo, about 1.5 hours away. Golfing is another popular activity in the area. 6. Salto El Liman. One of the main attractions on the Samana Peninsula, El Liman Waterfall is an impressive sight. Water cascades out of the jungle over a rock cliff to a moss-lined pool below. Access to the waterfall is generally on horseback from the town of El Liman. The trail is steep and muddy. Swimming in the pool is allowed, although be prepared for a bracing dip, the water is generally ice cold. The waterfall of Cascada El Liman is located about 20 kilometers from the town and the port of Samana. 5. Isla Saona and Parque Nacional del Este. While Parque Nacional del Este, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, is a serene place of natural beauty and habitat for countless plants, animals, and birds, most people know the park for the beaches of Isla Saona. This island is a tourist magnet, with all kinds of day trippers from the nearby resort destinations of Punta Cana and La Romana. The soft sand beach and turquoise water are what most people would imagine if they were to picture a tropical island paradise. But, despite the fact that there are no resorts on the island, it is a lively destination during the day, as catamarans and speedboats drop tourists on the beaches to relax in lounge chairs and soak up the sun. If you are tired of the scene in Punta Cana and looking for an outing, you can hop on a Saona Island day trip from Punta Cana. A small speedboat will whisk you over to the island for a day of relaxing on the beach and playing in the shallow waters. 4. Kiteboarding on Cabarits Kite Beach. Around a headland from Cabarits main beach, about a 20-minute walk along the waterfront is Kite Beach. This small area has its own unique vibe. In the mornings, the beach is quiet, with the exception of walkers and runners or people swimming and stand-up paddleboarding. In the afternoon, when the winds pick up, kiteboarders descend on the beach, and the sky fills with kites. The sand is a riot of colors with kites waiting for the best winds to materialize. A few restaurants along here offer casual food, many with a particular focus on vegetarian food and other healthy offerings. On Friday afternoons, a free circus offers entertainment at the end of the beach. Even if you are not a kiter, it's worth coming to see the spectacle. Cabarit hosts the annual Master of the Ocean competition in February, where the best in the world come to compete in kitesurfing, windsurfing, surfing, and stand-up paddleboarding. This is a great time to see some incredible kiting on Kite Beach. If you are interested in taking up the sport yourself, numerous schools offer lessons and hotels cater to kiters. 3. Cabarit and the Beachside Restaurants. Cabarit is known for its relaxed atmosphere and huge, crescent-shaped beach lined with casual restaurants where visitors can dine right on the sand. Unlike the Dominican Republic's resort destinations like Punta Cana or Puerto Plata, this town is not full of all-inclusive resorts and packaged vacation tourists. Instead, Cabarit attracts free spirits, backpackers, retirees, and kiteboarders who come here to spend a few weeks or months, particularly during the winter. If you are staying in nearby Puerto Plata, you can day trip to Cabarit to spend a day on the beach, enjoy a meal, or do some shopping. In the early evenings, especially on weekends and Tuesdays, musicians often perform in the local beachfront restaurants and provide entertainment as the sun sets. 2. Puerto Plata and Playa Dorada. Along the north coast, looking out over the Atlantic Ocean, the resort destination of Puerto Plata and the beautiful stretch of beach known as Playa Dorada is one of the Dominican Republic's biggest tourist draws. This golden sand beach is lined with luxury resorts, although much less densely packed than what you'll find in Punta Cana. This area is also much more subdued and has more of a tranquil feel. The beaches are not busy with boats and water sports, although it's a beautiful area for swimming or snorkeling. You can walk beyond the resorts to undeveloped beaches backed by palm trees and forest. 1. And the last one. Whale watching in Samana Bay. Each winter, from December through March, thousands of humpback whales enter Samana Bay to mate and give birth, making this one of the best places to see these beautiful giants in the wild. The city of Samana, on the Samana Peninsula, is the main departure point for whale watching trips. The city itself holds little else for travelers, but the whales are such a popular tourist attraction, many companies offer day trips here from various destinations around the island. If you are passing through on your way to Las Galeras, or if you are based in nearby Las Torinas, less than an hour away, you can stop in Samana and sign up for a half-day whale-watching trip with a marine biologist. You can also do a 12-hour whale-watching day trip from Punta Cana, which involves a short flight and a shuttle bus to the boat. That's all for now. If you have visited one of these places, let me know in a comment below. Subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to give me a like. Thank you.